This mass is offered for the following intentions: soul of Walter D'Souza, souls of Andrew Correa and Maria Correa, thanksgiving to Our Lady of Fatima, soul of George Rodrigues, soul of Juliana D'Souza, deceased members of De Cruz family, soul of Harry D'Souza, and all souls in purgatory.
All the ends of the earth, all you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord, for the Lord of the earth, the master of the sea, has come with justice for the world. Break into song at the deeds of the Lord, the wonders he has done in every age. All the ends of the earth, all you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord, for the Lord of the earth, the master of the sea, has come with justice for the world.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear sisters and brothers, today we celebrate the Feast of the Divine Mercy. The Lord Jesus reconciled himself, his disciples to himself after the resurrection, and empowered them to reconcile all of us with him and with one another. And so, to prepare ourselves then to celebrate these sacred mysteries, we pause a while to be sorry for our failings. You were sent to heal the contrite, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of the Father, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord.
glory of God the Father. Amen, amen, amen.
Let us pray. God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast, kindle the faith of the people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, and by whose blood they have been redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The full number of those who believed were of one heart and soul, and no one said that any of the things that belonged to him was his own, but they had everything in common. And with great power, the apostles were giving their testimony to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. There was not a needy person among them, for as many as were owners of lands or houses sold them and brought the proceeds of what was sold and laid it at the apostles' feet, and it was distributed to each as any had need. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response: give praise to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever. Give praise to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Aaron say, his mercy endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, his mercy endures forever. Give praise to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever. The Lord's right hand has done mighty deeds. I shall not die, I shall live and recount the deeds of the Lord. The Lord punished me severely, but did not hand me over to the death. Give praise to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever. The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done, a marvel in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice in it and be glad. Give praise to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever.
A reading from the first letter of Saint John. Beloved, everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ has been born of God, and everyone who loves the Father loves whoever has been born of him. By this we know that we love the children of God, when we love God and obey his commandments, for this is the love of God, that we keep his commandments. And his commandments are not burdensome. For everyone who has been born of God overcomes the world. And this is the victory that has overcome the world, our faith. Who is it that overcomes the world? Except the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God. Testimony concerning the Son of God. This is he who comes by water and blood, Jesus Christ. Not by the water only, but by the water and the blood. And the Spirit is the one who testifies, because the Spirit is the truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Have you believed, Thomas? Because you have seen me, says the Lord. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
On the evening of that day, the first day of the week, the doors being locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he said this, he showed them his hand and his side. Then the disciples were glad when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I am sending you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you withhold forgiveness from any, it is withheld." Now Thomas, one of the 12, called the twin, was not with them when Jesus came. So when the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord," he said to them, "Unless I see his hands and the mark of the nails, and place my finger into the mark of the nails, and place my hand into his side, I will never believe." 8 days later, the disciples were inside again, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were locked, Jesus came and stood among them, and he said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands. Put your hand and place it in my side. Do not disbelieve, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "You have believed because you have seen me. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet believe." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written so that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that by believing you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today's gospel finds the disciples huddled together, frightened, locked up in the upper room. Frightened of a manhunt for the disciples of Jesus who was crucified. A disturbed conscience at the fact that they had deserted Jesus and left him to his fate at the hands of his enemies. To add to that, shattered dreams. Into this, the risen Jesus comes, frightening them all the more because they thought they were seeing a ghost. John tells us that it was the first day of the week. The first day, so it's a new week, indicating a new beginning. One of the last words spoken by Jesus was, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." Jesus' first words to his disciples are, "Peace be with you." Earlier, I understood this greeting as meaning, "Let's have peace," or, "We are a peaceful people, so let's put our differences aside." Later, I learned that this has nothing to do with Jesus' peace. Jesus is out to announce a new world. When Jesus says, "Peace be with you," he means, "God be with you." Because to have God with you is to have peace. Peace is not something. It is not something that men and women sit down together round a table to discuss. When Jesus says, "Peace be with you," he is saying, recognize that God Himself is with you. And we are going to have a new beginning, a new way of looking at the world and addressing the world. That's what he wants you to know when he says, "Peace be with you." The next thing he does is he breathes on them the Holy Spirit. By this, the risen Lord is reconciling his failed disciples to himself. On recognizing that they have been forgiven, the disciples are filled with joy. Having experienced the gift of the risen Lord's forgiveness, they are sent out with the power of the Spirit to offer forgiveness to others, to offer the same gift they have received to others, forgiveness. When Jesus says, "Those whose sins you forgive, they are forgiven them." This gift and mission is given to all of us who have been baptized in the risen Lord. Having received the risen Lord, we are all called and sent out as ministers of reconciliation. When we receive anew the Lord's forgiveness, we in turn are expected to forgive others. Of course, the sacrament of reconciliation is a privileged moment of reconciliation. We receive the Lord's forgiveness in the sacrament. We in turn are expected to extend this forgiveness to the others who have hurt us. There are other and more frequent moments of reconciliation. When we say to someone, "I'm sorry," and the other accepts our apology, Jesus stands there in our midst, helping us to break out of the situation. A situation can drain us and everyone involved in that problem. He gives us His peace. He gives us God Himself. Today we are celebrating the Feast of the Divine Mercy. As we acknowledge our need for mercy and receive it, let us share this mercy with others, mercy which fills us all with peace. So then, when we say peace be with you, it is God that we share with one another. And because we share this, because we share God, we are destined to live for eternity. But most of all, we are destined to feel that life is worth living. In spite of all its difficulties, with all its pains, because Jesus is there and what He gives us is peace. Let us all profess our faith together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, the only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Our response, Merciful Lord, hear our prayer.
Merciful Lord, hear our prayer.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, bishops, priests, and all the faithful, that each will bear witness to the love and mercy of God. We pray to the Lord.
Merciful Lord,
hear our prayer. For our world leaders, and especially those who serve in public office, that they govern with true compassion for the lives of the most vulnerable among us, especially unborn children, the elderly, and persons with disabilities. We pray to the Lord.
Merciful Lord,
hear our prayer. For all of us to whom Jesus extends His divine mercy, that we may always trust in Jesus, be drawn into His compassionate heart, and celebrate His mercy by extending it to others. We pray to the Lord.
Merciful Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are suffering from this pandemic, that God may grant health to the sick, strength to those who care for them, comfort to families, and salvation to all the victims who have died. We pray to the Lord.
Merciful Lord,
hear our prayer. Let us pause and pray for our personal needs. We pray to the Lord.
Merciful Lord, hear our prayer. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this bread we offer, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine we offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that your offering and mine may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and good of all His holy Church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblations of your people, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and his rising, the life of all, has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your praise as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, Lord God of hosts. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Oswald Gracious our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, his spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant a peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God,
who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Spiritual communion prayer. O Lord Jesus, since I cannot now receive you in your sacramental presence, I beg you to come spiritually into my soul to enrich me with your holy grace and make me truly your own forever. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in me in the spirit of your holiness, in the fullness of your power, in the communion of your mysteries, in the perfection of your ways. O divine guest, give to my soul a strong, lively faith, an unbounded trust, perfect humility, an abiding sorrow for my sins, a total abandonment to your divine will, and a perfect loving union with you in mind and heart. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Lord Jesus, thank you for the blessings and graces you have given me through this spiritual communion.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal Sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
St. Michael the Archangel, defend us on the day of battle. We are safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, Prince of the heavenly hosts,
by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the other evil spirits who prowl throughout the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
St. Michael,
pray for us.
A happy feast to all of you.
Pray for relief from the coronavirus. Almighty and merciful God, who show your love to all creation everywhere, hear graciously the prayers we make for all those affected by the coronavirus in various parts of the world. We come before you asking for an efficacious control of the outbreak, for a healing of those affected, for the victims and their families. We thank you for blessing the efforts of our research scientists working on the development of a vaccine. We pray that these vaccines will be effective in combating the virus and its mutants and in controlling the spread of the pandemic. We pray that the vaccine be available for all our people, even the poor and those in rural areas. We pray for doctors, nurses, and health workers who are in the front line of this battle, that they be kept safe and have the strength and courage to continue their heroic efforts. We pray for the government and health authorities that they take appropriate steps for the good of the people. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
I will sing of the mercies of the Lord. Forever I will sing, I will sing. I will sing of the mercies of the Lord. Forever I will sing of the mercies of the Lord. With my mouth will I make known your faithfulness, your faithfulness. With my mouth will I make known your faithfulness to all generation. I will sing of the mercies of the Lord. Forever I will sing, I will sing. I will sing of the mercies of the Lord. Forever I will sing of the mercies of the Lord.